Humans love fire. Don't believe me? Do you ever watch fireplace videos? That these exist should tell you something. It probably goes back to our hunter-gatherer days when we lived in caves and the shared fire at night meant warmth and safety. There's nothing cozier than sitting around a fire and roasting marshmallows with some good company. Maybe there's even a guitar or a ghost story. But now, imagine your fun campfire goes wildly wrong. Some fires can get so big and so strong that they burn down miles and miles of land and cause colossal destruction. These uninvited fires that take over our landscapes are the hot topic of today's video. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. So, at what point does a simple flame become a wildfire? Wildfires are large, uncontrolled fires that spread rapidly through vegetation, like forests, grasslands, and brush. They are powerful natural events that can occur anywhere in the world and are known for their ability to change landscapes dramatically in a short amount of time. The science behind how wildfires start and spread is influenced by three main things: fuel, oxygen, and a heat source. Fuel is anything flammable in the environment, like trees, dry leaves, and grass. Oxygen is all around us in the air and is necessary for any fire to burn. The heat source could be something like a lightning strike, a campfire left unattended, or even a discarded cigarette that ignites the dry fuel. Once a fire starts, it can spread rapidly, driven by the wind, which provides a fresh supply of oxygen and also carries it across the land. The heat from the fire can actually preheat the fuel in its path, making it easier to ignite and cause the fire to grow even more quickly. This process can create a dangerous cycle where the fire generates its own wind, which can make the fire grow even faster. This is why wildfires are so unpredictable and difficult to control. Did you notice that wildfires can start due to both natural events and human activities? Among the natural causes, lightning is a common trigger. When lightning strikes, it can instantly set forests and grasslands on fire. Volcanic eruptions can also start wildfires because hot lava and ash can set nearby vegetation on fire. If you're interested in learning more about these powerful natural phenomena, check out the rest of our Natural Wonders video series on the Socratica Kids YouTube channel. Unfortunately, many major wildfires are the result of people taking risks or being careless. Leaving campfires unattended or not fully extinguishing them can also lead to flames escaping and spreading through dry, highly flammable land. Also, discarded cigarettes can smolder and set fire to plants on the ground. Weather also plays a role in both the start and spread of wildfires. Wind can carry embers long distances, which can then ignite new fires far from the original flame. Also, high temperatures can dry out vegetation, making it more flammable and ready to burn. Yikes! Let's take a step back and talk about fire itself. It seems like an obvious thing, but what is fire really? When you study chemistry, you'll learn that fire is a combustion reaction, which consumes a flammable material and releases heat and light. The flames are just the visible part of the chemical reaction. Have you heard that saying, "Where there's smoke, there's fire"? Smoke is often just as dangerous for people and wildlife. Inhaling it is terribly bad for you, even deadly. But what is smoke? Smoke is a mixture of ash and incompletely burned materials, carried up in a cloud of water vapor, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and other gases. You get smoke when there's not enough oxygen for the fuel to burn in a combustion reaction. That's why we blow on fires to get them going. Back when we heated all our houses with fire, we all knew to use this device, a bellows, to blow extra oxygen on the fire, like an extra set of lungs. This should also remind you how important a factor wind is for wildfire. Want to take home a souvenir of these natural wonders? Visit our website for smart, fun posters that are funny and fact-filled. Find the link below. Now, don't get me wrong. Fire is fire, but when it comes to wildfires, there's actually a few different types. We can use these categorizations to understand where and how wildfires burn. Surface fires are the most common type of wildfire. They burn through the top layer of vegetation, such as leaves, grass, and low bushes, and they move pretty quickly. Surface fires can be less intense and easier to control compared to other types of wildfires, but they can still cover large areas and cause considerable damage. Crown fires happen in forests and leap from treetop to treetop, sort of like a monkey, but much more dangerous. These fires are driven by wind and can also spread fast. Crown fires are one of the most dangerous and intense wildfires because they burn very hot, consume large amounts of land, have large flames, and produce tons of smoke. These are harder to fight and can lead to significant ecological and property damage. Finally, ground fires burn below the surface, consuming the organic material within the soil. These fires might not produce large flames visible above ground, but they can smolder for weeks or even months. Ground fires are challenging to detect and extinguish because they can burn without giving any visible signs that they're burning, like smoke or flames. Then they can resurface far from the original site. That's pretty sneaky. After a wildfire, it might seem like the area is completely destroyed, but nature has a remarkable ability to heal and grow. Over time, the environment begins to recover in stages. First, the ash left behind from the fire adds nutrients to the soil, which helps new plants start to grow. Some plants, like certain types of trees and flowers, have seeds that only open and sprout after being exposed to the heat of a fire. So, a wildfire can actually start the process of bringing new life to an area. In the weeks and months following a fire, you might see small plants and wildflowers start to cover the ground. These plants are very important because they help to stabilize the soil and prevent erosion when it rains. As more plants grow, animals that fled the fire begin to return to the area, attracted by new growth and the return of their food sources. Who knew some positives could come from wildfires? When it comes to putting out wildfires, we have some very important people to thank. Firefighters. Firefighters are like the superheroes of our very flammable world because without them, wildfires would burn much longer, hotter, and farther, and we sure don't want that. When a wildfire starts, firefighters rush to the scene with special tools like shovels and chainsaws. They use these tools to cut down trees and bushes to create a gap called the fire break, which stops the fire from spreading. Firefighters also use big hoses to spray water on the flames, or they might drop water from the sky using planes and helicopters called air tankers. These air tankers can fly over the fire and drop lots of water and other materials that slow down the burning, like a giant flying fire extinguisher. Sometimes firefighters even start small, safe fires on purpose. This might sound the opposite of helpful, but stay with me. These controlled burns really do help by burning all the leaves and twigs that could fuel a bigger fire. By doing this carefully, firefighters make sure there's nothing left to burn if a wildfire comes near. Now, not all the work should fall on the shoulders of firefighters. They may be superheroes, but they're also only human, and they can't be everywhere at once. There are things that you and I can do to stay safe and prevent more wildfires from happening. Always set up campfires in designated areas and make sure the ground around the fire is clear of dry leaves, twigs, and other flammable materials. It's crucial to keep a bucket of water or a shovel nearby just in case you need to put out the fire quickly. Also, never leave your campfire unattended. Be sure to pay attention to current fire risks and regulation. There are rules set by experts who know when the risk of wildfires is high. If the risk is high, they will set a temporary fire ban, meaning no lighting fires until conditions are better. Being careful and following the rules helps keep everyone safe and protects our beautiful natural environments. I have a feeling the next time you roast marshmallows, you might see it a little bit differently. From firefighters' bravery to the different types of wildfires to fire safety and prevention, we hope you see there's a lot of layers to this story. Don't forget all the ways you can contribute to a happy and healthy Earth, and that includes practicing fire safety. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.